My name is Sam Chan. I'm a professor of neuroscience. Ever since I was a very young boy, I was interested in why people got sick. And then over the years, I think one of the ways to find out is really you stop seeing patients. So that's how I got into medicine in general. To keep our brain young is very simple, actually. You keep using it. If now you look at most people in their daily life, they always look at their laptops and they look at their Wi-Fi or whatever. They're not using the brain that much, and that is not good. You have to constantly use your brain in a useful way, not just to reading things, but you have to think about things. So basically, use your brain is the only advice I would give to anybody. We have to look at it in a different way. Just to let a person live longer is not a good way of doing it. A person to have a long and healthy life is what we should do. So what you do is, if you want to prolong a person in terms of physical age, you want to improve his mental age as well. So what we do is we want to actually not only improve our physical health, but we want to improve our mental health. Again, use the brain. So translational medicine is a new term that came around about 10 years ago, and it has many definitions. And the most popular definition is that to bring a study from the laboratory into medical practice. A typical example of that is what they did in the drug companies. They actually evaluate different kinds of medications and then finally to come up with a new medication. And that's one of the ways that most people would define translational medicine. But then over the years, because of the financial aspect of it, translational medicine actually becomes something that is very important financially. You actually make people very rich. But to me, translational medicine has a third meaning, and that is how practicing doctors and research scientists will work together to come up with the correct solution for patients. So this to me is together the physicians would, let's say, come up with an observation from a patient and they don't know why, so they talk to the scientists, and the scientists would come up with an answer to that question. And that, at the end, the person who got benefit are the patients. And this, to me, is what translational medicine is all about.
And people kind of talk about this concept of the quantified self and becoming completely self-aware through technology.